I believe the correct term for it is a clove hitch. And I found a small clip of loose end belly tying a knot. Let me see if I could squeeze it in right here.
Site, loose end belly, George's older brother, still makes fireworks by hand.
Okay, we're not going to look as cool as Lou's end belly tying this knot. He's probably tied so many knots he could do it backwards. But whenever you tie, this is a piece of quick match. Whenever you tie fireworks things together, like for example, when you want to connect your finale, you got to connect one piece of quick match to another. You want to tie a fuse to another fuse. You know, and if you want to make it that it's really secure, you have to knot it. And this knot, I think, is pretty common in fireworks. And a lot of times, I myself have forgot this knot. You know, if you don't tie it for a couple months, and it's like, wait a minute, did it go this way? Did it go that way? And I try to come up with a way to remember it. And I'm going to see if I can remember it myself next time. And maybe you'll enjoy it too. Okay, I'm going to do the clove hitch. I'll do it once first. And then I'll show you how I'm doing it. Okay, that's the clove hitch. When you see guys that work with fireworks, particularly old timers, you'll see them walking around, they cut a bunch of strings, they hold them in their hand, then they go around and tie things up. And let's go through the clove hitch. Now, a way I come up with to remember this knot, and we'll just go through it slow, it's going to be over the top, right, left, through the V. Over the top, right, left, through the V. Over the top. See, there's times you'll get out there, you'll be going, does it go this way, does it go? Over the top. Pull it to the right. Okay, it was over the top, right, left. And if you look, it kind of makes a V. And you go right through the V. In the middle, and then it's going to look kind of like this. Then you find the position, pull it tight, trim it. Okay, let's do it again. Over the top, right, left, through the V. Over the top, now it's to the right, left. And you can see the V. See the V right there? And right through the V. Over the top, right, left, through the V. Alright, so we're going to tie something together. Put this on it. Over the top. Alright, we can start here. Over the top, right, left, see the V, pull it through the V, then you can just kind of slide it into place. Right there, should hold it. Kind of work it around the camera and pull it tight. And that's it. That's going to stay on there. And you make it look neat. That's the clove hitch. Remember, over the top, right, over the top, right, over the top, left. And right through. It's secure. Okay, let's finish it up. Tie something on this end. Okay, this is two pieces of quick match tied together. You can see it's strong. That clove hitch will hold. And this is like a penny wrapper in between it. And when you put two pieces of quick match together, you could actually peel some of this out and stick it in so it has some fire. But what else could you use the clove hitch for? One more thing. Okay, now we're going to put a piece of visco into the quick match with the same knot. Over the top, right, left. Let me make sure you can see it. And through to V. Kind of pull it all up. Catch it where you want. Secure. All right, one more trick, putting two pieces of visco together. See how that works with the knot. Okay, there's the final. Two pieces of visco. That's pretty secure. Into the quick match, into the bucket, all with the same knot. And I guess if you really wanted to secure it, you could, after you make it, you could put a knot in it. Okay, one more time with the knot. Okay, we'll just put one right here. Over the top. To the right. To the left. And you'll see the V. And right there. Comes up. Clove hitch. Pretty secure. That finale can shoot around all at once. And it should hold.